Hi children, in this video we are going to see 6th standard mathematics chapter basic geometrical ideas topics plane, point, line, line segment and ray. So in this video we will learn more about what is a plane, what is a point, what is a line, what is a line segment and what is a ray. So finally, exercise problems. First of all, let us learn what is a geometry. So geometry is a branch of mathematics concerned with a position, size and shape of figures. The term geometry is derived from the Greek word geo and matron. So here geo means earth and matron means measurement. So geometry is the branch of mathematics which deals with the measurement, properties and relationships of points, lines, angles, surfaces and solids. So let us learn more about this figure. Next, let us see what is a plane. A plane is a flat surface. It has length and width but no height. A plane extends indefinitely in all directions. Only a portion of a plane is drawn and is represented by a rectangle or a parallelogram. So let us learn what is a points. So a dot is known as a point. A point is used to represent any exact location or a particular place or position. A point can be denoted by a capital letter of the English alphabet. So for example, here we have the point, point A, point B, point C, point X, point M and point P. A point has no dimensions such as length, breadth or thickness. That is, it has no size. So let's see some examples of points are the sharpened end of a pencil and the pointed end of the needles and pointed end of the compass. So now let us learn what is a line. Yeah, line is a straight connected set of infinite number of points. It has no end point and no fixed length. So it extends indefinitely on both sides. Hence, it cannot be measured. So here we are having the line AB. This line AB have no end point and no fixed length. So here we can read as line AB or line BA. So we write it as AB or BA with the symbol of the line above the letters. So like this. So let's see few examples of lines or a road, railway track, and length of a sea. So next, coming to line segment. Line segment is a part of a line. It has two end points and a fixed length. We can measure the line segment. So here we are having the line segment MN. This line segment MN having two end points and fixed length. So we are readers. Line segment MN or line segment NM. We write as MN or NM with a symbol of line segment above the letters like this. Let's see the few examples of line segments are tube light, inch tape, pen, and a baseball bat. So next is a ray. A ray is a part of a line. It has one end point and no fixed length. So it can be extended only one direction. So here we are having the ray X, Y. This ray X, Y have one end point and it can be extended only one direction. So it can be a readers only ray XY. So do not a readers ray YX. So that is we can start from the end point only. So next we can write as XY with the symbol of ray, the above letter, like this. Let's see the few examples of rays or torchlight, arrows, and sun rays. So let us see the difference between line and line segment. The line has no end point. It does not have a start and end point. The line segment has two end points. It has start and end point. Next, your line extends in both the directions. But a line segment does not extend in any directions. The length of the line cannot be measured. But the length of the line segment can be measured. So let us see the difference between line and ray. The line has no end point. It does not have a start and end point. But the ray has only one end point, which is known as the initial point. A line extends in the both direction, but a ray extends in only one direction. So next let us see the difference between line segment and ray. The line segment has two end points. It has start and end point. But the ray has only one end point, which is known as the initial point. Next, a line segment does not extend in any directions. But your ray extends in only one direction. The length of the line segment can be measured, but the length of the ray cannot be measured. Next, coming to exercise problems. Exercise 4.1. The first sum. Name the terms which of the following examples represent. First one. A tiny dot made by chalk on the blackboard. The answer is point. Second one. A grease obtained after folding a paper. So the answer is line. Third one, wire stretched between two hooks. So the answer is line segment. Fourth one, a mark on the ceiling for fixing a fan. So the answer is point. Fifth one. A beam of light from a lighthouse. So the answer is a ray. Next, the second problem. Join the points given below. How many line segments do you get? So here the given the points are P, Q and R. So first we can join P and R and P and Q and R. So let us count the line segment. So the first line segment is PR. The second line segment is PQ. The third line segment is QR. Therefore, here we are having three line segments. So there are the line segment PQ. Next, the line segment QR. And next, the line segment or P. Next, the fourth problem, count and name. So first, we want to write the points. Here, the points are A, B, C, D, E and F. Next, the line segments are AB, BC, CD, DE FA, BF and CE. Next, the sixth problem. Is it possible to find the midpoint of a line? Give a reason. No, it is not possible because a line is a long thin mark on a surface. A line has no end points. It extends indefinitely on both sides. Since a line does not have a fixed length, so its midpoint cannot be formed. Next, the seventh problem. Draw two points C and D. How many lines can you passing through both points? So first we can draw the two points C and D. So the first point is C, the second point is D. So let us join the points. So here we get the line segment C and D only. So therefore only one line can be drawn. Next, the eighth problem. Draw a point O. How many lines can you draw passing through a point O? So first we can draw a point O. So let us draw the lines. So here we can draw many lines. Therefore, infinite number of lines can pass through a single point. Thank you, children.